Hey guys, your boy Capriza, and welcome to my brand new secondary career mode with Aleiko Mother Jedi. You mentioned at the end of the about doing career mode with Westerlo that my new career mode was with a team that is in the Champions League. They're a big team. It's Aleiko Madrid, a two-timers up in the Champions League, former her La Liga winners not too long ago under Diego Simeone, so I will try to replicate some of those feats. And maybe he better that by actually winning the Champions League, because, you know, I'm a winner. But yeah, here we are. You can see the team among them with their or 4-4-2 seemed like the best formation, because I couldn't bring myself to play one up front. I could, realistically, and as you can see, I brought back Miranda because I have absolutely no idea why he's out on loan. There's probably a good reason for it in real life, why he's out on loan at Inter Milan, but in FIFA,
hello everybody.
I have absolutely no reason to have an 86 rated center back out on loan. That's just
mental. Nothing like the opening day, and the home team here certainly will have high hopes of finishing in the Champions Cup place.
And of course, I've the man himself, Greasy Griezmann, up front.
Full of hope and expectation.
Oh, a really good
promoted last season.
I don't. You know, this is probably going to be, you know, which team I have is probably going to be one of the more easier career modes. I didn't need to bring in a right mid video. I brought in Felipe Anderson. I'm thinking of my boy at left back, Felipe Luis. He's at left back. Felipe Anderson, I brought him in from Lazio. He is the only new signing in the team so far. I do have
Anderson,
one youth player who I brought in.
Energetic player, likes to get his foot in too. Loves a tackle.
You'll only see him in like Champions League.
This is how they love to play on the break.
Yeah, Copa del Rey when it comes. Oh, Griezmann! How did you not score there? The first goal of the season should have been Griezmann's. How close was that? What was that? He almost scored an own goal. Let's have a look at this.
Yeah, and he's gone for the corner with power.
Oh, hit the bar, hit the post, and bounced on the fucking line. Oh my god. I have to come up with a big win because Barcelona have already beaten Real Betis by 4-0. So, yeah. Probably looking at the thing and saying why is Correa playing instead of Gromero?
Match with his new team.
Yeah, he's bound to be nervous, isn't he?
Gromero was playing really bad in preseason, so I decided I'll give Correa a shot up front. I mean, out of all the players, I think he was disappointing me the most. Everyone else played for. Okay, Griezmann was on fire. And I don't mean that like the song on insert player name here and then saying that it is on fire song. He was literally just ripping the teams that were playing to shreds. Unbelievable. I can see why Manchester United are always fucking signing him in every fucking career mode. And they've already approached me. I told them to rightly.
Just as well.
I told them. I gave them all night. Motherfuckers. I just wish I could have actually sent them an email saying, fuck up.
Punch to clear the danger. Shots on here.
Oh, there we go. First goal of the season. And wouldn't you know it. Greasy Griezmann. Although, That didn't exactly show his pace to the best of his ability, to be honest. That was an absolutely wonderful first goal of the season. That's not a bad one. That's better than, I'd say, 80% of the goals I scored in my West Ham career mode, because they were all mostly just, you know, they were all okay goals in the West Ham career mode. And I scored well in excess of 100 plus goals in that career mode. And the first
goal, it's 1-0.
League goal I scored in this career mode. And yeah. Griezmann's going to have a tough time getting top goal scorer. You'd assume he'd be the guy who'd be favourite to get it from my team. Maybe Correa.
Referee's done.
I did. Extremely well, you know, I could have brought in a different striker, but, you know, I remember playing with using Correa on previous FIFA, and I really enjoyed playing him. I think he is vastly underrated. I know he's a popular player amongst career mode players because of his pace. He's got
Griezmann.
He's got
it's a quick break.
Potential, and he might get himself a goal here. Yes, indeed. So it's a goal and an assist for Antoine. He's been at 2-0. Yes, I'm fucking coming for you, Barcelona.
Touch. Of a maestro.
Don't even die.
On into the net.
Yeah, he's having a little chuckle to himself.
I mean, the keeper might have saved it if he didn't jump. Oh no, it went past him. I don't know why. The way he jumped, it almost looked like he jumped up and it went past him.
Just widen the margin here to 2.
That made me think it would just hit him if he stood there. But it would have gone past him regardless. So he jumped for no reason, only to confuse me. And
comes in strongly.
He did. For what? It's
looking good. Now the opposition have a
yellow card for straight away. He's already yellow card, and this is his debut. This is his first game in front of the Atletico Madrid fans. At the Galadome. And excuse me if I'm pronouncing it wrong. I think that's how it's said. There might be a Spanish pronunciation of how it's said. But whenever I hear the English commentators for the La Liga, they call it Galadome. So, excuse me if I'm mispronouncing it. It's not my fault. For once, it's not my fault. And you know, it's good to have players actually know the names of. No one here I don't know the name of. You will notice I have Gaitán playing instead of Carrasco.
Well, we're into the second half.
It's going to be tough. I'm going to have to probably rotate him and Carrasco because they are both
fantastic.
And I don't understand why Atletico Madrid have two left mids and they have absolutely no one on the right.
Saw the pass coming and got there first. Attacking now.
That seems to be a glaring issue. And again, if I get another bullshit yellow card with Felipe Anderson, I'm not going to have anyone on the right either.
Nicolas Gaitán. Some potential
is,
in this move.
Felipe Luis.
Here's the cross, Felipe Luis.
Cross in. Ah, I didn't make the connection I would have wanted for a correct score for the second of the game and third of the season. He'd be another one who might get a good few goals this season.
Scoring opportunity, really.
He stays in the first team, and that goal will definitely come in good standings with me. Yeah.
On to the attack now.
Getting the start over.
He can clear it here.
Over.
Oh, chance! This game isn't all about.
Romero, sorry. As I was about to say Griezmann because he's just scored. But I was trying to say Romero.
Well, he's doubled up.
He's everywhere.
Second goal. And he took it.
Good error, not in the ball to Griezmann, in off the post.
Let's see the replay now.
He's off to a flyer. Two goals and an assist. I mean, he's been involved all three goals so far.
Situation here, 3-0. We've reached the hour mark. Half an hour to go.
Sometimes I think my tongue has a mind of its own.
Nicolas Gaitán.
I'm gonna actually. I was gonna say, do I now have him on the bench? I thought for a second I didn't have him on the bench. I'm gonna bring him on for.
Then strongly.
Felipe Anderson.
And we will have for you on EA Sports the next fixture.
I know he doesn't actually. The home side can't play on the right. I mean, if he could, I could just play them on the right.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. We see a substitute coming on.
In regard, it does mean I can. Oh! Oh, a bit of fancy stuff up there. Koke! Oh, you dick! How did you not score that?
Real Madrid have a corner.
I'm a bit disappointed that Griezmann didn't score after his fancy.
To be used. And we've got one coming on now.
Oh, that would have been a fantastic goal. That might have outshone his opener.
Well, that means it's a corner now.
One more goal and we've matched Barcelona.
Miranda! It's a high-class header and a world-class save.
Well, it was a good height for him, but what reflexes, what agility he showed there.
20 minutes of the 90 still to play.
There's Griezmann, make a run, or don't, just let me.
He'll need to try and get the ball back now.
Stranded there, her wing to get tackled. Yeah, that's a good fucking
move. Has broken down.
Show. Are they passing it around the back? They don't want me to get the third goal.
Interception made it look easy.
Sorry, the fourth goal. Crossed it.
Great chance.
Worked his way into the position. Oh, what a save. The keeper, despite having conceded three goals, he has had, good few saves in this match.
He's got his tackle in.
I'll give him that.
Now.
Of course,
Marcos Llorente.
But the way my career modes have been.
Romero.
Being with a random low teams, I was kind of expecting a team like
that will help playing.
But luckily, my randomizer picked Atletico Madrid. If I'm being honest, if I was expecting any big team, I was like, it's probably.
And then with the challenge and the ball broke free.
I'm real more threat from
Atletico Madrid in these positions.
I'm not gonna. That bullshit. I am indeed more of a Barcelona in terms of La Liga. I don't consider myself a Barcelona supporter, but you guys know I've been to
Romero,
the Camp Nou. I've been there. The first ever game I ever went to. I mean,
well, there's still a chance for something to happen because there's three added minutes.
It was part of
Madrid now attacking dangerously. It could be a two.
No, I was really.
That's a brilliant goal. Well taken.
Why he chose Barcelona and not Liverpool? I don't.
It's a hat trick today.
Still appreciate.
He's really been on form.
See the Camp Nou, unbelievable. This was back when the likes of Ronaldinho.
Even two goals in the game, but he's.
This was before Messi.
Way, I mean, and he's got
I've never seen Messi playing.
Work rate, he's runs off the ball, and been top class.
10, 11 years ago. When Ronaldinho was
playing. At 4-0.
Messi was probably still on the youth team.
Success here as the whistle blows for.
And no one ever had heard of him.
Well, with all the preseason behind,
anyway,
we'll talk about this game.
That is why I'm more
3 points.
Everything clicks into place. Doesn't always happen after so much rehearsal.
Favorite Barcelona.
It's been a really good day for them here.
Real Madrid.
What a brilliant performance from this fella.
But, you know, I'm not going to let that affect my career more here at Atletico Madrid.
What a hat-trick.
He did complete the hat-trick just there at the end of the game. And collects the match ball. If he didn't get 10, I will be very shocked. Because, no, he did get a hat-trick. He got freaking... He got the assist for Correa, his goal as well. He did indeed get a perfect 10. Oh wow, Carrasco came on and had a better game than Felipe Anderson. Maybe I should start him. To be fair, I don't think Anderson had a shot on target. Saul got an assist as well, so did Juanfran. And who I'm a bit worried about because he's already gone down. So his rating is worrying me, but you know, he got an assist. It's good. No, Anderson did have a shot on goal apparently. Wow. That too. Unfreaking believable.
La Liga. Atletico Madrid 4.
Those would be the two corners, wouldn't they?
Malaga 2. Osasuna 2.
This is the young kid I was telling you guys about. You can see him. Hugo.
Real Madrid.
Isvaldo? I mean, it wouldn't be a career move for me if I didn't butcher somebody's name. You're probably saying to yourself, why is Griezmann in the training? Don't worry, I'm not trying to make him into like a 97 rated megastar. Or to outshine Ronaldo and Messi. I'm just trying to up his stamina, to be honest. That's all I'm doing. Who did I want to put in? Thomas. He's really close to getting up to 77, so I won't put him in. I'll leave Henrik in, even though he's in the last training session before I start. For the first game, he actually went up to 868. As you can see, he's perfectly at the starting point. Before paying 269. Quickly get this done. As well, though. Oh. Went up a good bit, you know. He might go up in the next training session. I honestly do not know who my second game is against. I mean, I can see their crest, but I'm not gonna lie, I don't know what their name is. Transfer offer for Koke. Jesus Christ, Bayern. Let's troll the shit out of Bayern Munich here. Give me 95 million. I really don't want to sell Koke. I really don't. You know. Legends? Whatever their name is. I just want to quickly check. The fuck, Real Madrid lost their first game. What? I'm sorry. What? Am I the only one who sees this? They already dropped 3 points. What a bunch of fucking wankers. They may as already run themselves out of the title race. Rest of that, they've played 3 games. How have they played 3 games? Hello? Everyone else has only played 2 or 1, dickheads. Fucking hang on, wait for everybody else. And we finished the season before the rest of us. That won't win you the title, you have to actually...
Because you won't know when what people have done. You'll be sitting at home waiting to get the call. Did we win the title or not? Just, I'm gonna quickly swap. I mean, this is the best way I can do it, really. Is, try to give them each equal minutes. Because, you know, Carrasco is a good player, and Gaitán is a good player. And I don't want to insult either and say one is better than the other, because, really, it's heads or tails, really. Because both are fantastic players. Carrasco, unbelievable. Well, especially if he is on form, he is really good. And Gaitán, with that pace, can just ruin anyone. I mean, if it were pace-based, then definitely Gaitán would be
delighted to have you along
for the
ride for this game.
Much faster than Carrasco, but you know, I'm not going to pluck hairs because I have one.
Welcome from the home fans, Martin, after playing their first
pretty
game.
Much decaying one
fan. Getting after the promotion campaign that they enjoyed last year.
And I think Miranda will probably go down as well because he's like 35 or something.
Against
like
a team that really talented outfit. Plenty of flair, and I think they can finish in a Champions Cup slot. They need a good start, but well capable of it.
Well, here is the team sheet.
Yeah, he might not,
the home side.
I
think that back four is really important for them. They've got to be strong and solid, but they've got a bit of protection, haven't they?
They have. They should have more than enough. I mean, they're all good defenders in their own rights, but in front of
maybe
them,
maybe one can outperform the other.
Hard. And they could be a fit on the front foot. We'll wait and see.
Atletico Madrid make one change. Starting in goal, Jan Oblak. Felipe Luis starts with Juan Fran, fullback position. Koke starts alongside Saul in the middle of the park. And in attack.
Carrasco had a good performance after coming on for the last 30 or so minutes in the first game. I need to change the corner taker. It's fucking greasy. Why is he taking?
Defender to it first.
He's a tall enough player. He's more than in the box.
He scored!
As well as correct, yeah, as like a poacher, because he's in there making an absolute fucking menace of himself.
Well, the keeper may think he could have done better there, but I don't know.
You guys, this thing is being cleared the ball. It's their own fault, really.
Well, let's take another look.
If you don't clear the ball, you're going to get punished. It's a. Correa's second goal of the season.
Opened the scoring, 1-0 here.
The first goal that Antoine didn't have a goal, didn't score or set up.
Griezmann.
Unless you count the fact that he took the corner.
Trying to switch on the.
But that would be really clutching, clutching at straws, plucking at ears, and all the other.
Cross in, and it didn't.
Stuff you can come up with.
Arriving in the middle.
For how you can say, oh, he probably was.
I mean, Madrid winning possession.
In a way, yeah, he was, but you know, he
Mari.
Proper assisted. You know, I don't think it'll go down as anyone assist unless it gives it to the defender just to rub it in.
Madrid. Koke. Yannick Carrasco. Keeping the move going.
And shoots! Griezmann to Carrasco! I might have earned him.
Stopping the pass getting through with.
Starting click.
Good piece of.
Pacing the
anticipation.
Next for Carrasco. Right now it's going to be rotating. Yeah, but, you know, I don't know. Like I said, if one outperforms the other, I might have to. Give him the preference.
And in goes the cross.
No reason.
He sliced
really
through.
Really,
them apart.
I kind of were excited
there. We all thought he was going to score.
Really, it was just, you know, he was already in the team, so I said, you know, I'll give Gaitán the first game. I'll probably bring on Gaitán about the same time I brought on Carrasco in the first game. Just, you know. Like I said, I want to try and get the same.
They've cut the pass out there, and maybe
that relieves
the pressure.
So about the 63rd minute, I think it was, they replaced Felipe Anderson
There's good progress with this attack.
Still in the first game.
Crosses in.
I don't know what time it was he actually went off. So, I don't think it was immediate, but that'll be about the time to make the substitution. Let's see how Gaetan comes into the game.
Shots on here, and the goalkeeper.
Ooh, good save from Oblak.
Well, they've got a corner.
Make sure I keep it.
Madrid, they do.
Already got one. Unless that yellow card,
particularly in front of goal, but they've also.
I really don't know how clean sheets work
defensively.
Randomly not give your goalkeeper a clean sheet when.
Oh, great work by the keeper!
The goal.
Behind for the corner for.
I think it might be down to yellow cards, but I don't know how that's the keeper's.
In with a chance. Got his shot off now.
Oh, yes.
And he's scored, and it's a big
it's
moment.
The first goal of the season for Seoul.
Now to two ahead. They played well to this point, but sometimes a two-goal lead can be.
His potential is really good.
It is certainly the kind of match
I
that
like Madrid
we were coming here to
I was
see
really
with the better team playing the better football.
Yeah, and they've handled that expectation in terms of being strong favourites, so fair play to them for that.
I will enjoy using him. I just get the feeling that he's going to be one of those players who is key to what I do in this career mode.
Impressive statistics here. 9 shots, 4 on target for Atletico Madrid.
Well, not too bad from the strikers.
Dances his way through. Oh.
Stop here. They've got a corner now.
See, pace. Is just ruining the defense of my opposition. They just can't fully handle it.
And he's in there with a header.
They can't seem to handle corners either. Because I've scored 2 goals from the corners and it should be 3.
And there goes the whistle for half time. The scoreline is 2-0. It's a great moment for the away team to get a goal just before half time to really.
Real Madrid and Barcelona are both playing. I'm more interested in Barcelona now than I am in Real Madrid because they are already 3 points behind me.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. And he goes for goal with his head. That is a high-class header.
3-0. Correa instantly making it 3-0. And the assist for Mr. Anderson.
That goal for Atletico Madrid.
Felipe Anderson.
Coming in from the right. Was so invited. Wonderful delivery.
Yeah,
great
wrestler.
Ball, great goal. Look at the players. Delighted with it. Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
He's already cop to Antoine.
In Sua.
He had any clear-cut chances, really, has he?
He's Sal.
Griezmann.
Won it back with an interception.
Far cry from the first game where he ran the show. Although he might get a chance here. Will he make me eat my words? Yes, he will.
On to Andreas Mann, and he's found the back of the net again. Oh, this is what you call leading from the front.
And you probably noticed Griezmann is wearing the captain's armband. I decided to make him captain because, you know.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
He is the heartbeat of the Atletico Madrid team. Well, their team is absolutely fantastic. Ain't no doubt about it. That team they will suffer badly if they ever lose Antoine Griezmann. Whoops. Didn't mean to pause it.
It's turning out to be a comfortable game, this 4-0.
Yeah, Antoine Griezmann, Correa wasn't level with him for long. Griezmann must have realized, hang on a second, this motherfucker's trying
just
to take my
chance to tell you about a confirmed transfer here. Mats
position
has signed for Bayern Munich.
I don't even know if he's not.
£45 million, and for that kind of money, the fans will be expecting something pretty decent.
Suarez.
They cope with it well defensively.
More than likely, beat. They probably all got one, and then and someone from the midfield or defence got there. Because that's exactly how it works. Challenge. Or maybe it was a sneaky last-minute goal from Sergio Roberto, like a poor PSG will attest free kick to that happening. That is unbelievable, by the way.
The manager's
fair
going.
Fair play to Barcelona. I thought when they scored the fifth goal, I was like, "Oh my god, poor!" I really felt bad for them because I thought, "Man, they got the fifth goal. If they hadn't conceded that goal."
And it will involve
Walter Cavani.
Side. It's the next fixture in the league.
They would be laughing at the moment. They'd be on their way to the next round. And then they get the sixth goal. Now, some people are calling Barcelona for some dives.
Well, the winner of the Golden Boot in Euro 2016,
a real Suarez and Neymar.
Antoine Griezmann. And I must say, he's playing up to those.
I will point out that Suarez was doing that diving shit at Liverpool as well, so it's not like this is new from Suarez. I'm not saying it wasn't a dive. He definitely was. There was no contact at all, or very little. Like, he really played it up, but obviously the referee just.
You could see the deflection.
I mean, he must be new because he clearly did not know. Or else he just doesn't watch the Premier League, because clearly he wasn't aware of what Suarez was, what was part of Suarez's game. I thought he cut that out, to be honest. I hadn't seen him doing it in a while. I guess he figured it was a big situation that he felt like he had to do something. He always pulls out something in big games, whether it be good or bad.
So we're coming down now towards the last 15 minutes. He's got his shot off now. And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save.
I mean, I don't condone it. PSG, nothing they can do about it, really. As an Irish fan, on one hand, and I kind of feel like now France knows what it's like to get screwed over by some cheating. But on the other hand, I'm like, then again, PSG didn't really have anything to do with that.
By no means a formality this match for Atletico Madrid, but they had it under reasonable control.
Ireland didn't deserve what happened with Henry.
And the outcome, I think.
And no, I did not mean. I didn't accidentally say his name wrong. That's his name. It's not Henry.
Oh, saved by the goalkeeper. Full stretch. And it's back for another corner.
And just so I don't get any Arsenal fans hating on me, I know it's not actually Henry. But, you know, he's a fucking cunt and he can fuck off. And that's not me saying that as a Liverpool fan. Because even as a Liverpool fan, I really enjoyed watching him in the Premier League. Now he can fuck off. As I'm not a big international fan, but even that made me sick to my stomach. I was like, "Are you fucked?"
It's tough for the defenders. They keep conceding.
France could have beaten Ireland without cheating. I mean, they probably would have beaten Ireland without cheating, but you know, they resorted to cheating. Oh shit, I completely forgot to bring on Gaetan. Shit.
Well, the ball's gone up.
Crasso's rating is probably going to be a bit higher than his, isn't it?
Good forward play from
the last.
There's the interception.
Right. Yeah, next game, the first game of the next episode, regardless of what Crasso has done in this game, Gaetan full 90 minutes in the first game. In the second game, I'll make it to Gaetan when Carrasco starts. I'll bring him up. Definitely. I may even bring him at halftime just to fully make it up to him, because that is totally my bad.
Athletic Bilbao 2, Barcelona 2, Espanyol 1, Malaga 2. Real Betis.
Barcelona dropped points as well.
Coruña 1.
Everyone fucking dropping points.
Celta Vigo 2. Las Palmas 2. Granada.
Real Madrid have already dropped points. And Barcelona have already dropped points. Yo, you know what my price is, Brian? 95 million, man. You have to remember, I have to replace him as well. And yes, I know I have Thiago and Gabby. But let's be honest, they're not really going to play a big part. Real Madrid dropped more points, they only got a draw. Are you kidding me? Real Madrid have 1 point from two games. When would that ever happen? Yo, this might... I thought this was going to be more of a challenge with Barcelona and Real Madrid squads. They might not have caused me any issues whatsoever. Alaba. 2 goals for Alaba. Ronaldo only has one. What the hell is going on? I'm massively confused. I'll figure it out in the next episode. Thanks for watching. I'm Joy. Smash the like button for the brand new remote, which is off to an interesting start. And I'll see you all next time. Until then, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.